Yes, I'm Thomas. I'm from Belgium. I studied in Belgium applied economics and also business. And today I hold a position as head of logistics for an e-commerce website. And also I'm co-founder of Minpi. Minpi is an online mattress e-commerce business that is based in Indonesia. Well, the future of omni-channel e-commerce, I believe it's two forces that will strengthen each other. I think e-commerce will be the dominant one, but the brick and mortar stores will really support the e-commerce business, because to enhance the user experience for customers, it will be important for the broader range of the brand image. So customers can really affiliate with the brand and with the products. I think it will be a good support for the e-commerce business, which will be the dominant one. Well, in Southeast Asia, the big roadblock will always be the last mile delivery, because the user experience of customers with e-commerce is quite important. You need to make sure that the customer is in control of the last mile, and I think that's still a challenge to get more efficiency in that part of the supply chain, because you have a lot of options, and to make sure that your supply chain is synced with every aspect of your business is important, because otherwise you will lose a lot of money and effort if the supply chain is inefficient. And I think it's a big roadblock to pay attention to this, because for instance in Europe, about a transaction as an e-commerce site is about 60 euro, and 20% of that goes into shipping. So if you can really optimize that, that is really, it goes to your bottom line, that's profit. So it's important to overcome that and to optimize that. And I think definitely in your checkout process, you can minimize that roadblock by offering a lot of options and not, for instance, delivering or providing to the customer same day delivery or next day delivery. No, give the option to the customer and not just promise something, but really give them the option so you can spread your volume to make the supply chain much more efficient. Well, retail can definitely compete, but I think it will be, as I said, a supportive role for the retail. And I think in, let's say, 3 to 5 years, it should be really a mixture of retail physically and e-commerce, because with the e-commerce dominating, let's say, the user experience, because every time you make a significant purchase, you first will search the content, the description, the information. So that will be important, and I believe that definitely for retail, they will need to go to virtual assistants to make sure they can keep up with the technology and the trends in the e-commerce business. But the advice I would give to an entrepreneur that wants to start an e-commerce business is really to start with the value proposition. I think a value proposition for an e-commerce business is really crucial to have at the start, because it will provide a lot of direction, and also it will force you to make some decisions about certain strategies, like for your marketing strategy, for your supply chain strategy. And I believe that the value proposition should be specific. So it's really why customers want to buy from you and not from from the competition. Also, it should be pain focused, so which problem it will solve, and it should be exclusive but desirable, so that it's really something that people want. why question is important, and I believe with we have a great value proposition. It's that we show on our homepage, the perfect mattress for everyone. It's a large, or applies to a large group of people. Our value proposition, but with young, dynamic, images, brand, perception. We want to really build the connection with our customers. So really, the brand connection is very important, and that's really something I would advise every entrepreneur: start with your value proposition, and from there you can build the brand in your business, because this will give you good guidelines to a successful start. Thank you for having me, and thank you for the interview.